Greeting from Snake Mountain Boat Works on Wednesday, August 9, 2017. We're working on the 1959 17-foot Chris Craft Sportsman. As you can see, things look markedly different than they did the last time we visited this boat and John. So I'll hand it over to John, who's going to bring you up to date as to what he's doing and why, and in particular why we see all those toothpicks standing up and all these brown spots that look like chicken pox. Take it away, John.
Well, as I put the deck on and the covering boards on, I had already put some of the Dutchmans in them that were in the seriously bad beaten up spots. But as I put the covering boards on, I had to fit each board to another board, making sure the framing was all nice and even underneath it so that it would come into it the best it could. A lot of these boards, with the age of them, have quite a bit of warp to them, and of course I had to make sure the framing was all really, really straight. I got the boards down nice. As I plugged the boards, I had to fill in around the plugs with fillet epoxy with stain in them so that it would be the same color as after I stain it. And the toothpicks that you see that are sticking up are because of all the screw holes that are left in the covering boards. I had toothpicked the framing, but I wanted to also toothpick the covering boards as I put them on. And as I put stuff together, I tried to sand in as much as I could before I actually put it together so that when I'm sanding on the boards, I can avoid sanding cross grain on the other boards and clean it up a lot quicker. So,
and we were able to save every four plank except the two little corner ones, right?
Right.
We saved everything else.
Everything was saved except for these two corners, which were totally demolished when they came off.
Yeah. And I see you've got the pass-through in, and
yes, pass-through is all in. The dash is in. I got the dash covered up with plastic right now because I'm going to be bleaching the deck, and I don't want to get the bleach on the
Vinyl.
Vinyl on the dash.
That's right.
So.
And you finally put an additional coat of bilge paint in the bilge, right? Because there were too many ghosts of.
Yes, I did. I put the extra coat in the bilge.
So, John has invested a tremendous amount of time getting to this point, but had we not done so, we would have had just a terrible result. Now we'll have a nice smooth crown and the foredeck. You had to rebuild.
I had to structurally rebuild this whole inner frame underneath this deck right here in this corner because there was structurally not much holding this area right here, this joint and these two covering boards and this first board right here, and I believe that's why this board was in such bad shape.
Right.
On each side is because everything was flexing right here in these corners. Plus, something hit pretty hard right here in the beginning because this area right here was rebuilt.
And if I remember, back here were these, the two covering boards on the pass-through right at the gunwale. You discovered they were basically floating.
Yes, there's a little block underneath the back corner of these. And on that side over there, it had four screws in it, but the block was broke. So the boards were basically floating away from each other. So when you try to sand them, they become sanding easy or even. This side here had a block under it, but it only had the two screws in this pass-through board. And this other board was just sitting on top of the block with not enough block to actually get some screws in. I made a wider block, one matched each. I made ones that matched each side. And got four screws in each one. It's all solid now.
And then, if I remember, the aft deck framing also needed some rather significant
yes, it did.
Right. Rebuilding.
Ended up doing some work right in this corner back in here and tightened up all the framework. And where these boards were right in here, we had to put in new blocks underneath that, and I'll solve it. But now, nothing's going to move.
That's great. So it won't be long before we'll be bleaching her, then staining her, and of course we have to bleach the king plank blonde, and the ribbons of trim that run along the covering boards will also be blonde. She's going to look quite different very, very shortly, but of course she really looks different now than she did when you saw her last. So thank you so much from Snake Mountain Boat Works. Bye-bye for now.